crossovers in those land speakers at all. They're in that box. I'll get them out, I'll show them. Don't you know, we're talking about a bit of illusion that sounds like a whisper. Don't you know, we're talking about a bit of illusion that sounds like a whisper. While they're standing in the welfare lines, crying at the doorsteps of those armies of salvation, wasting time in the unemployment lines, sitting around waiting for a promotion. Don't you know?
46 years later, and we're still making the same product.
Crying at the doorsteps of those armies of salvation, wasting time in the unemployment lines, sitting around waiting for a promotion. Don't you know, talking about a riddle of illusion. Threw a stone into the bottomless sea, and tied to it was a hope that you're coming back to me. The seed of a hesitating son has given birth to 4 stereo amplifiers, and then
in each speaker
there's an amplifier in each loudspeaker, a mono amplifier for the bass and sub bass.
Whoever the complainer reported does it, music can stop.
Seattle. Hello, welcome.
I'll now demonstrate the effect that polypropylene cone material has on sound.
My funny Valentine, sweet.
Best way I can do it is to filter my voice, so there's a certain brightness of and clarity in my voice. But if I was to play the same voice over polypropylene, it just loses that slight detail, that slight air. Mm-hmm. Now the thing is, if that's all you had ever heard as a reproduced voice over a loudspeaker, you'd think that was fine. It's smooth, certainly smooth.
You make me smile with my heart.
What you're missing is actually that. It's just that air which has just gone from the reproduced sound over polypropylene. This effect here is mirrored with this one here and so on, all the way around. So it's a pair of speakers.
Unphotographable.
Just got to look at these, and there's no two pairs the same next to each other. Put that and use the glue nozzle. You make it run around, use the glue nozzle, press the button, get the glue out. So it magnetises pretty much anything.
Check.
of that information as possible, but we don't want our turntable to have an effect on it. And that is the core value of all reader to on turntable. These are machined out by our engineers.
Having our own test facility, for many years we used classic old school wet analog wound flutter meters, but they always needed servicing and you're always relying on someone basically making a judgment call.
When we started making moving cores with the very first Afita, which looks quite prehistoric now compared to the new ones, this was what we thought was the smallest iron cross we could make. Now we're working all the new range now uses this tiny little microcross. Eric is one of our dealers from the States.
Nice to meet you.
Based in Seattle. But yeah, Ash is our supervisory moving coil, and he'll give you, if you want to have a look in there first before we start, you can see just how small the assembly is. And we very much make use of people's skills in their hands in Rega. It's really important. Sense of touch is an incredibly useful tool. That's moving many times more than it would when it's in a record. These little stereo generator sets, if I grab one, I won't try and fit one in, but these generators are created on this jig.
So he writes that on every
product.
Something different,
yep.
On every,
yep.
One.
Something different on every one.
Test procedure, safety tests. Really careful when they're doing that. Luckily, no walls there. It's a nice little display. Got nowhere to store them. They need to go out. So these are ready to go. Soak test, these have all been built. We can't ship everything at the end of the month to hit our figures.
Poor people gonna rise up, get their share. Poor people gonna rise up, take what's theirs. Don't you know you better run, run, run.